there anyone here who doesn't want to hear an Avengers Endgame spoiler? No? Endgame spoiler is fine? Fantastic. I don't have to censor myself. Okay. I am a man. A real man. As I always carry protection. In the form of tissues, that is. You see, I cry a lot. And I'm not ashamed to say that when Tony Stark died in Avengers Endgame, I cried. As I marveled at Marvel superheroes as a child, and when a child turned hero in Pay It Forward. I was a total mess, I confess, but no less of a man. You see, my manliness does not fear a few tears, as real men are strong, and real men have issues. As for too many years, we have misused our voices, and now our unspoken needs bleed the blues in abandoned houses of ghost towns where we never took our emotions to. So it's time to break down. It's time to break down the man code. As real men, they care. Real men wear their heart on their sleeves and bear their souls where souls meet. And real men don't need to prove their manhood by building walls. As real men need connection. Real men feel lonely and real men need protection, if only from themselves, as the male to female suicide ratio is 3-1. And I don't know about you, but I feel lonely sometimes, like real men do. And I am a man. A real man. I think real men are attractive. You, sir, with the blue shirt, you're an attractive man. Joshua, you are a damn fine, attractive man. And I have no problem in admitting this, so much so that more often than sometimes, women have tried to hook me up with attractive men. But I don't feel offended when I recommend it as a romantic catch to any gender. You see, real men feel comfortable with their sexuality, so I don't feel the need to defend mine or question yours. My manhood is never dependent on being seen as gay or straight, because I am a man, a real man. As I don't like having sex. Sometimes. Sometimes. You see, real men, sure, real men are horny and real men they lust, but real men also deal with a sex drive gone bust. And we need to trust ourselves in having this necessary conversation. So let's talk about sex. Education. Because mine came from porn. So when my ex-girlfriend, in the middle of sex, asked me to spank her, I felt conflicted. Did not predict this, did not want to inflict pain, felt constricted by my beliefs, but then thankfully remembered all the movies I'd seen. I knew how to do this. But as soon as my hand hit her cheek, I instantly felt sorry and apologized. Felt compromised in my ability to satisfy her. I was confused. I had questions. What to do next? Spank her again? Apologize? Should I? What is the right amount of force? So let's break down some myths surrounding men and sexuality, shall we? See, real men have manners. They understand consent. Real men also have anxieties, fears, concerns, doubt. We're not constantly on cloud nine with our clothes off. Before observing your body, I still feel self-conscious about mine. And with porn as a guideline, I define my success by the sounds you make and the time it takes for you to climax. But now, I want to turn my self-consciousness into conscious sex. I'm still learning. Concerning myself with different questions like, how far do you want this to go? What feels good for you? What parts of your body are sensitive and sensual? I'd like to do this, how about you? And time is not an issue because real men would never dismiss your pleasure. And I am a man, a real man. I mean, come on, just look at these arms. They may not be the biggest, most muscular. Truth be told, they're rather slender, but they're strong enough to hold you. You see, my manhood is tender, because real men give proper hugs regardless of gender, and I've got many to spare. So whenever you feel that the world doesn't care, just know that my arms are always armed with a hug. And I've got a shoulder for a buck to lean on because I am a man, a real man. As I am absolutely, absolutely certain. Certain that when it comes to flirting, I will choke. You see, the last time I told a woman I liked her, I broke a sweat, stuttered and stumbled over all of my words, and that particularly hurts being a poet. As real men are supposed to be confident, right? Real men also feel insecure. And I doubt myself more than my doubters. And at times, hate myself more than my haters. And the voice in my head is as loud as a whisper, but I can still hear it. You're gonna get rejected. She is just not into you. Asians, well, Asians just aren't sexy. So when it comes to sex appeal, I feel insecure like real men do. Because I am a man. A man who doesn't give a damn about football. Who runs away from brawls because these guns are not made for fighting. And these hands would rather be writing poetry than a history of violence. I don't do drugs, don't drink alcohol, and I fall stupidly in love, faster than Cupid, that little shit can shoot its arrows. I can't grow a beard, so I know that this baby face is not considered the manliest, but I am a man, a goddamn real one. Thank you very much.